go past.
Around there.
Well,
it's here.
Get
it
done. Come
on.
Minority might just do this, but.
Without suit and length of spare.
carry a lot of things, a lot of things. Six Greyhound buses. And 75 people seated upstairs. 100 Volkswagens. The Beatles. Somebody figured out that you could put 752,000 hockey pucks in the galaxy.
On some more of the details, but here we go. Cameras at the ready, the 135 and the B-52. Like we are up here, we're trying to figure out where. Sorry, too. They are supposed to be coming in on their run shortly. International Guard, Selfridge Air Force Base, the four F-4 Phantom 2s, McDonnell Douglas Phantom 2s. And a diamond formation coming in from your right. Up to 71,000 feet. On combat, they have a range of approximately 1,000 miles, 2,300 mile ferry range. They weigh about 28,000 pounds empty. They're a big aircraft. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, they're coming in from your left to right. They will be coming in left to right with a high speed burner climb right in center field. As the warbirds wind her up, here come the Phantoms. They'll be doing an afterburner climb to the left. Cameras at the ready. They're coming in here at 450 knots. The F-4 Phantom from Michigan Air National Guard. Ready to cover your ears. Standing by for the burners. Angle of the wing continuity. A variable.
Thank you.
shot out of the boundaries of London International Airport. Just an amazing display. Watch the spiral going up. Get out of your view. Better to modify it a little bit and make sure that everybody can see what is going on. As the Tomcat comes in from right to left, this will be the high-speed pass. This will be done at 600 knots. Right to left, the approaching Tomcat. Gunfire 173 from the fighter squadron 101. He is making one more pass and then he will make his turn. So he might have to drop it. We're keeping a watch. It looks like it'll be a high speed pass coming into the pitch. Yeah. Watch for it in the pitch. Watch the wings change. And he'll be coming in right to left for his landing. He's going to stay down.
There's one over here.
Oh, that's good. That's
Oh!
I believe without the firing of a single shot. And Germany might be part of the prosperous and today. But there were four. One by one we were all sucked into the orchestra.
Left to right. Here comes the roll coming out of the half Cuban eight. and they should be setting up to do a loop right in front of the crowd. It's still in the Vic formation. That is the latest model of the pits, the S2S, 260 horsepower. At the top of the loop, nice and clean smooth. See just the power coming down the backside of the loop. Turn the little Pitts aircraft out there. We've seen other Pitts teams here, of course, before, but this is the first time in North America the Royal Jordanian Falcons have performed. They just picked up these aircraft new, replacing their older Pitts S2As. They came up to us from Florida. Their support aircraft is a Britain Norman Islander parked in front of the crowd. Getting ready for the line of this hammerhead from right to left, the Royal Jordanian Falcons. Smoke is on. Turning in a wing over maneuver to come as is trying to stay in the cockpit of the tiny little S2S Pitts. Very pretty maneuver. The inside outside Cuban 8 of the Royal Jordanian Falcons. Back in from stage left to complete the 8. It's a shame we have that wind up there today. Would have left a very nice 8 in the sky. Flying a very pretty show. Give me a nice cool ship for you. I know I see a lot of cameras. There goes number one. Here goes number two. There goes number three. Now number one is going to have to slow it down a little bit. So number two is trying to catch up to number three. They have to end up in the next position. So he's putting on the speed to catch up with Paul. And here comes nice job out. Number three aircraft. A very pretty split loop. From the Vic position, right back to the Vic formation, the Royal Jordanian Falcons. Yeah. Do another wing over at the north end of the field, disappear in that tiny puffy little cloud, come back on center stage for a quarter clover leaf break.
Thank you.
5 feet, pull up starting to an altitude of 6. And you'll get the acceleration from the afterburners very shortly, and you'll hear it.
Oh, look at that. The Warlocks sure have done their homework, haven't they?
Check it and see. Profile on speed. No, we're coming up. two master technicians, and without them, we would be sitting on the ground rather than airborne as we are now. The crew today consists of Wing Commander Chris Lum, OC 50 Squadron, Flying Officer Greg Edge, co-pilot, Flight Lieutenant Martin Pedley, navigator, and Flight Lieutenant Bob Palmer, Air Electronics Officer. Bob, you see, needed a little rest. He's been talking so much this afternoon that he offered me the chance to stand up here and give a little bit of commentary. The engine that this aircraft has got are 201 series Bristol Olympus Rolls-Royce engines, developing 1750 thrust, whereas we have the 301 that series engines developing 20,000.
Landing lights out, coming around. 165 knots. Coming along, high speed, cool sky,
World Aerobatic Contest, where he won the World Championship. When he was learning to fly, in aerobatics would be his specialty. You can certainly see why now. After separating from service, he began building airplanes that he felt was trying for the championship, and as well as building and redesigning the airplane he used. That was unheard of in combination. He would be an untried pilot in an utterly untried aircraft. The airplane was written in for a major airline in the United States. New Jersey, and he has a wife and two daughters. Just keep on rolling. Just keep on rolling. We're watching the computer roll. If you had a chance to have a quick look at the airplane before the show, you'll also notice you can almost look through the aircraft due to part of the design.
Graham from Sault Ste. Marie. Graceful fan burst.